Hey there, you are. Come on over here. Welcome back to another Spiritual Oracle card reading. My name is Brian Nesline. I am a clairvoyant, psychic, intuitive, empath, spiritual card reader. And I'm going to read these cards for us, for you, right here and right now. Now look, this reading is absolutely for you, if you decide that it is. It's that simple. You can enter into any experience by setting an intention, an inner tension, an inner knowing, an inner blueprint. You just make that decision that, hey, you know what? This reading, it's got information that's going to be helpful for my highest good. I'm just going to kick back, allow it to wash over my consciousness, and I'm going to see what types of words and emotions bubble up through the reading and through my own memories and my own beliefs. So let's get into this. Here we go. Ooh, what's that? I hear the word starseed, starseed. What are we talking about? Well, the starseed is the idea that we are from the stars. We come down to Earth to live out a mortal life. And what we're doing really is we are bringing light into the world. We are light workers, light beings. Seeds of the starlight are happening with all of our words, all of our interactions, all of our emotions, all of our experiences. Aw, look at that soul traveling down from the stars as you, as this white light, immaterial, non-material being coming into the world to live out a person's life called you. Now, you can see all the blue here. All that blue represents the blue throat chakra. We've heard this before. It is our words. It is the most important part of what we can do here on Earth is use our language, use our symbols, use our words. This is really the center of it because it creates like a box or a focal point for the light to embody, to come into the world. You know that's how we're doing it. We make meaning, communication, commune with people and situations around us by using our words. So know that one of our most important gifts here on Earth is our communication, our words. In relationships, you can always pause and breathe and just speak the truth of your own words. Try to get across what you're trying to say. A lot of times, you can do what you see up here in the card with all the little star dots. You can use a bunch of different words to communicate the same thing. That way, you're going to be really honing in for the other person what you mean by things, because words mean different things to different people. If I just said the word God, that could conjure up in you a memory of maybe the Catholic religion or a different type of a view of God than I might be speaking about. But if I say God, source, universe, white light, if I use those four words to describe God as I understand God, it helps to give a clearer communication of what the meaning is so that we can commune as souls that are traveling to this space here on Earth to work together to expand the light in the world. We're always working together. We are not victims of this world. No, we are bringing down the big star seeds. Look at that big acorn to grow new things in the world. It's all green because that's the color of the spiritual heart chakra, representing our spiritual body. Again, this is us bringing down those green seeds or those spiritual seeds to grow in the world and for us to communicate with different people. That's why you see a squirrel and a dragon. Very different beings, but look, they're all happy, they're all smiley, they're using their words to communicate with each other. They're not victims of each other's words or meanings, and they're not victims of their own words or their own ideas of what the other person might mean. No, they are coming together to communicate so that they are able to grow these big seeds in the world. And what are these seeds? These seeds are expansion. They're an expansion of understanding and of light for each individual. That's what happens when we communicate as clear as we can with other people. We broaden each other's perspectives. And that's truly the gift each one of us has coming into this world, is we are unique expressions of God's source universe. We have a unique set of data or words that no one else exactly has fit together. All through our life, we've been collecting different experiences and different words and different perspectives. And when we bring our present perspective to situations, to our coworkers, to our family members, to the people around us in our neighborhoods, to whoever we're communicating with, to any relationship, when we bring our unique present perspective, we help them expand their own. And it plays on their ability to share their own perspectives with us. As you can see this, we are creating our reality together by sharing our words and our emotions. Look at the double-winged dragonfly. This represents how the two of us, or two people, can come together and create one new expansion, one new being, the dragonfly. You can see that that's really what's happening here. The dragon is getting flight by communication with other people. So always know that you are a unique expression of God in the world, that your words are really creating the type of experience that you are having, because our words are like intentions. They are forming that inner space, that blueprint, so that we can see the world through what we're describing. We're going to see out in reality reflections back of what we have been focused on, thinking about, what we are mulling over in our mindset. And you can see this with the Inner Truths card. That's what we're looking at. Here's that little green heart chakra with their little inner truths that they're dwelling on, with their little light. And as a result, the whole reality around them is a reflection of that. And you can see that it is a bunch of caverns and little spaces and little never-ending lands of expansion that we get to have as these little star seeds that are growing in the world. Each one of these seeds is like one of these little villages or little scenarios or little far-out scenes that we are getting to travel to and experience when we commune with other people. We are traveling as a soul in the world to these new spaces through our words and accepting that reality is being created by what we believe, what we act on, what we express. So when you're looking over at that other person, know that they are another person who has options for you to explore. As they bring the pearls of their wisdom, you can see it up in their crown chakra here, they bring their little white light pearls of data points, of star points that we talked about earlier, their little descriptions, their little new ways of breaking off that light for you. As you experience that, explore those options, see how they fit in with your new friend. Things right here show the tortoise, or that one that's protected by the shell. Why? Because you don't have to worry about their words influencing you or their words making you do things. It's more about being open to allowing this creative expansion of the light, this abstract perspective change that other people bring. So look at them all like a little child, meaning you adopt the idea that you are like a little child in this world, curious, filled with awe and wonder, and oh my God, what's up? What's going on? Something good is being shared. I want to clue in on it. I want to make friends with this strange reptilian, amphibian, interesting turtle, the one that I don't know much about yet. I want to be able to understand others by hearing their perspectives. All right. So we know that we are all here as the seeds of the stars. We know that everybody, no matter what they look like or say, they are all expressions of God, source, universe, the light in the world. We are open to these new perspectives so that we can boom, 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 boom. Come on now. Star seed it all up. That's where we started. That's where this reading's ending. Know this is who we are, each one of us. Oh, it's so beautiful when the cards come out to follow our words. And that's how it is. The signs are reflected by what we first say and intend up here. Then they come out in reality because we are creating an experience that we are hoping for, that we are desiring, that we are starseed bringing down into this world. All right, starseed, enjoy your soul travel. Enjoy your little journey on this little beautiful experience that we are all raveled up in. And one last little last card, just for the whatever of it, to take us out of this starseed reading. What's it going to be? Beyond the illusion of life, we are those ones who are living so big as a soul, traveling into this world as that dragonfly, butterfly, beyond illusion, word machine, with all that energy, all that light, all that nothing against us, one power, not two. You know that all your friends, all your enemies, all your everyone's, all the data, all the TV shows, all the books and every word, they're all here for you to expand your wings. Your joyful butterfly life is what's going to be singing true when you accept that this world is just here as a land for the stars to come and seed and grow into. Have fun being that starseed soul traveling beautiful being that you are. Enjoy looking at the other people around you and knowing that's who they are too. Have a beautiful time as you are renewed by your mind with that curiosity, that awe and wonder of the child that you are eternally. Take care. Pull down that little notification bell. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet. Go ahead and leave me a comment. Let me know how you're doing, what you're feeling, what you're thinking. Broaden my perspective by sharing something that's on your heart mind today. Take care. I'll see you again. Now look, there's over 375 other spiritually channeled messages on this channel. Go ahead and set your intention that you'll be led to one that would be for your highest good, and then just go there after this even. You can watch them morning, noon, and night anytime you want some spiritual inspiration. That's why it exists. Take care. I'll see you again. Goodbye. Welcome back to another spiritual oracle card reading. My name is Brian Nesline. I am an intuitive, empath, psychic, clairvoyant. Here I am to read some cards for you. Simply set your intention that this reading is for you, that you did not arrive here by mistake, because there aren't any. That everything is happening in divine timing, meaning that you're always in the right place at the right time. With this type of an attitude or an intention, we can sit back, relax, and be on our best awareness. Be wide-eyed, in awe and wonder like a child, open-minded to what's about to happen. Then we're going to see, hear, and feel things that are for our highest good. Let's go ahead and do that. Now, just let go and know, first of all, that you are a spiritual being having a human experience. It's very important to know that. Spiritual being having a human experience. That's going to give us all the worth of ourself. The worth of a self in the world is to embody the spirit and bring it in to this little iceberg island that you are in your personal life. Each person is their own little island, and each person is a little snow angel, meaning that we are a spiritual being having a human experience, a dual being. We're the light, and we are also the physical entity that is walking around on Earth with arms and legs to do stuff. You can see that it is the orange sacral chakra coming down. Why? Because that is the creative experience in our personal life. We don't actually make stuff happen in our personal world. What we do is we trust that the light or the love of God, Source Universe, is having a creative experience through us, living through our body, living through our personal self. And that's the true worth of a self, because you know how this is. Before we wake up spiritually, we're always like, oh, am I enough? Oh, I don't do this as well as that person. Or, oh, if I only had this, that, or the other. That's how we kind of judge our self-worth. But now that we're awake spiritually, we know that our self is 100% worth, because it is a unique little type of a box, or a unique little type of a expression, or a unique little puzzle that keeps changing in the world, that this one spirit, one light can operate through in a unique way to add variety into the world. You are that. No one else could be you. That's impossible. Think about it like snowflakes. There is no two that are identical, and all the experiences you have been through up to this point in your life are so intricate, so detailed, so different from everyone else's. That set of data is so unique that it creates a new variety of the light shining into the world over and over again in every little interaction, every relationship, every even mundane little thing, every word you say, every way that you move, all of it is unique. So know that the light is expanding through you, and that you really are acting as an angel of the light in the world so that God's Source Universe can expand. And look, all these other trees represent all the people around us who are getting the snowflakes of that white light coming down onto them, covering them. which is really just all of your gifts, all of your expressions are landing on other people, and they're getting to pick and choose through the little unique snowflakes that you allow to fall down. Ooh, and that's interesting too, when you think about it, because look, I'm wearing a shirt with snowflakes on it today. That's fun. I like when those coincidences come up, and when I draw meaning out of it, I can feel that burst of the epiphany or the burst of the higher vibration. Now, the other thing we're going to see here is that we want to make sure we look, she's looking to the seat. Often look towards this space. Look towards your identity as a spirit, often. Forget a lot that you are a self. Mostly remember that you are a spiritual being having the human experience. That there's not two. There's not a self and a spirit that are like jockeying for a position. No, there's just one that's alive, and that is the spirit of God, source, universe, and it is using your body as a conduit, as a channel, as an operating system, as a vehicle to move around in this world. The next card that comes up is surrender the habit of people pleasing. Oh, so now when we go into the world, we got to realize we are so unique and original that we can't really please everyone. What we can do is just stay calm, shine the light, and speak our truth, whatever that is. Now, other people are going to hear that information and interpret it the way they do, but if we can sit with them and talk a little bit, we might be able to paint a clear picture of our intentions and our expressions so that they get the light out of what we're talking about. If we're yelling and screaming, or if we are upset, or if we're scared, or if we are defensive, it's going to be more difficult, and we might end up sort of just like trying to fit ourselves into them, and that doesn't really work. We want to fit ourselves into our spiritual expression, not into pleasing other people. And this doesn't mean that we're going to be rigid and we're going to be like, oh, get away from me and all that crap. No, we're just going to be more relaxed, more observant, more observant. That means we don't act. We don't say yes or no. We don't do anything. We just observe until we're inspired. And when we're inspired, then we answer or we act. And we're not pleasing people then. We are pleasing our intuitive sense of our spiritual connection. That's what we're doing. So the way to surrender the habit of people-pleasing is just to surrender to the spiritual habit of going up here and doing what you honestly sense you're being led to do in the moment, or led to say in the moment. And it is a reinforcement of your own understanding that you are the spiritual being who is living through your personal people called you. So you're not even going to please yourself, really. You're going to be letting yourself go and just letting the spirit flow. And that's what we really want, is just to go with the flow. As we do that, we're going to just make the decision that all of our true heart's desires are going to bubble up with that flow of light, and they're going to get sown into the world. So we don't have to worry so much about trying to make them happen. We just keep walking forward, like it shows here, right to the edge of the green heart chakra cliff. Ooh, that just means that as we're exploring our moment-to-moment life in the present, the future gets laid out in front of us. Imagine this land just keeps expanding. That's what happens as we walk towards the light and we speak our blue truth. Then the land expands and we step out onto that. We are constantly creating in this dark space called the human history, our personal history. There's nothing here but empty space, and we are bringing light, or focusing on the light, so that it can manifest stuff for us moment by moment. We are an ancient traveler. That's why I chose this old guy here with his staff. We are one ancient God, one ancient source, one ancient living universe that is traveling through 7 billion people. One of them is you. So continue forward in this lone journey of the spirit that is using all of us to expand all of the variety of material things in the world, and a variety of heart's desires are all coming true for you and other people just by knowing that we are this spirit, knowing that we are 100% self-worth, knowing that we aren't really pleasing other people, but we are just following our own sense of intuition. That's what's going to get us down the road. And again, we're trusting that the things we want, we don't have to force. We don't have to try to please other people to get them. We don't have to try to please ourselves to get them. We don't have to try to trick ourselves. None of this crap. Just know that you're a spiritual being. Know that there's only one God, one source, one light. Know this, and you will break through to your new zones as you go across, looking at that light. So you're reaching the light, always reaching up to the light. and those things that you want are going to appear for the best of you. You know this is true. It has to be that way. We can't figure out how to get the things we want, but we can soar into limitless love, light, and joy. And as we do that, the things we want are going to just unfold on our path. This also represents the divine masculine and the divine feminine forever together in here. They're both following that blue light. You can see it in the cards. And they're both expanding their universe by their personal worlds unfolding. You can see when she gets to the end of the tunnel, it's going to appear. When he gets to the edge of the cliff, it's going to appear. This is a beautiful union of a breakthrough of a lonely little spiritual being having 7 billion human experiences over and over and over. We are creating more data into the world, more interactions into the world, and more light into the world. Let's pull one more card here, see what we're going to see. So really this is all about just accepting your identity as the light, relaxing and allowing it to unfold, really kind of being quiet, just knowing, hey, you got this. Whoever you are, you're me inside of myself. And we're just going to relax and watch as the light comes down and expands into the world. You can see it again here. You can see that it's all throughout these cards. They're all there just waiting for you to be amazed at how surprising it's gonna get as you trust the light. Oh, prepare to be blown away. Prepare to be filled with tears of gratitude. Prepare to know that everything you're really looking for and hoping for is all for you. Nothing can prevent it from coming to pass. Just relax. One last card. Let's see what it is. The existence card again shows this lone existence of who we are. And see it again here. We are just sitting on top of that green heart chakra. We are going ahead and keeping our eyes on the stars, on the light. You can see in all three cards, that's what's happening. Making our wish upon a shooting star that comes down and falls right into that seat of the spirit. You can see up here. And now we are able to bring that light into our world. Have it be a part of our self. Here you are, spiritual being having a human experience forever sitting on top of that petal of renewal all day long, eternity-wise. Take care, have fun. Thanks for being a part of this reading. Enjoy your mystical, magical, wow, wow, wow life. Have fun watching it unfold and your heart's desires just bubbling out for no apparent reason other than love and light got you back. Take care, subscribe to the channel. Go ahead and leave me a comment. I'll see you again. Goodbye.